For the EVF experts. My name is Bernd Gerstenberger. I will introduce you with AutoCAD Plan 3D. AutoCAD Plan 3D is a product for the plan industry. Never mind if you are working in a chemical industry, industry of water, wastewater, pharma, oil and gas, or nuclear power industry. It contains a 2D and a 3D part. You can handle specs and catalogs. You are able to define your own configuration very specifically. Also, you are able to create orthographic and isometric drawings with a report creator. You can create your own formatted reports. Let's start how it looks like. When you have just installed AutoCAD Plan 3D, you will see three icons on your desktop: Plan 3D itself, a spec editor, and the report creator. Let us start with Plan 3D itself. Plan 3D, you are working with projects. Everything will be saved in a project. So let us create a new project. On the first side of a wizard, note that you are able to create a world project. Also, you can create a project based on another project. Just check copy settings from existing project and browse for it. In the next step, you can decide which units you want to use, imperial or metric. Let us choose metric. On the next side, you have to choose a standard for your PIND ID drawings. For metric projects, the standards PIP, ISO, DIN, JIS, ISO are available. On this side, you set several paths to a project. Let's leave it as it is. So on this page, you have to choose if you want to have a SQLite project, which is a default value, or SQL Server project. If more than one person is working on the same project at the same time, I recommend to you create a SQL Server project. So let us finish the project. Now you have created your first project. Here in the project manager, you have several nodes. In PIND ID drawings, you're working with 2D drawings, while in Plan 3D drawings, you're working with 3D drawings. In a pipe specs folder node, you see all specs which are currently saved in the current project. We will talk later a bit more about the specs. In related files, you can copy different kind of files into a project as well, like files from Microsoft Office or images, etc. Whatever you want to add. So let us create a new PIND ID drawing and draw something. Just right-click PIND ID drawings to create a new one from a context menu. Here we go. Now, let us draw something. Therefore, we are using elements from a tool palette. Note that I've switched the workspace from 3D piping to PIND ID and the standard, which is the current standard used for this project, which is currently PIP. I will add some components now, and also note that I will tag them. is a button for the data manager. In the data manager, you can see already what kind of components are inserted to a current drawing or all drawing of a whole project. Note that we have here already some kind of reports available which you can export to Excel. Now let us create a new plan 3D drawing and pipe something there. Note that for plan 3D models we are using dynamic tool palettes, which means every time when I switch a spec, the tool palette will be updated by the content of a selected spec. When starting piping, you have to select where you spec and the size at the beginning. If you route a new line instead of using route pipe, you can also insert the line number tag directly to the assign tag dialog. The line number tag will be used for creating isometrics later for the production ISO. You can insert supports and equipments. For equipment, you can assemble your own equipment by selecting different parts. This custom equipment can be saved in separate templates. In the project setup, you can configure the project to your specific needs. For example, you can create custom Paint ID classes. Or you can set up your piping connection settings, how plan components should connect together. Also, there are specific sections for isometric and orthographic settings. Back in the model, it is very easy to create an orthographic or isometric drawing. Here I create an orthographic drawing. And now I'm creating an isometric drawing. Let us open now an example project how this can look now. So here's an example for a PNG drawing and here of a plan 3D model. Also, here's an example for complex orthographic drawing and here an example of an isometric sheet. Now let us look into the spec editor, where you are creating, using and maintaining specs and catalogs. A catalog is a library of components of a specific norm like DEM. You can create catalogs and also your own components in a catalog using some templates or using block-based AutoCAD elements. A spec is a subset of one or more catalogs of a specific specification which will be used on site. Both specs and catalogs are saved in a content folder. When they create a new project, the specs from here will be copied into the new project. Finally, I want to show you the report creator. It is an additional tool which will be used for creating reports which can be plotted or saved, for example, in PDF files. In the report creator, you're opening a specific project and afterwards you have to define what for components you want to include in the report. These are the queries. In the layout, report layout, you decide how the report should be formatted. Every change of a report can be quickly checked by switching the tab how it would look like. Now I'm at the end of my presentation. I hope I could help you with my introduction of AutoCAD Plan 4D. Have a great day. Goodbye.